day one in Brussels, and I took a trip into town to see where my friends work. Whilst Harris finished up some emails, Rob and I availed ourselves of the cafe downstairs, which is also a bicycle repair shop. Then we headed out for gelato. Rob is Italian and very picky about his ice cream, but he thoroughly approves of Glacier Bargello in the Place de la Liberté, where they also do vegan ice cream. Then we wandered about the city, looking at all the big buildings. This is the Royal Arcade, where there are a lot of very pretty but very expensive shops. Found this display of African masks at the Galerie de Dominico. I recognised a Po mask, a Kifebwe, and maybe a Tetela, but many others that I didn't know. Rob took me to the Grande-Place, which is this square with incredible architecture, all coated in gold leaf. It's apparently considered to be the most beautiful square in the world. Rob told me this a little understated, as though he didn't want to oversell it, but I do think it is incredibly beautiful. And I totally geeked out when he told me that the house behind my head is where Victor Hugo wrote Les Miserables. He wrote most of it on the island of Guernsey, but he spent a year in exile here, from 1851 to 1852. As Les Mis took 17 years to write, I reckon he must have scribed at least a couple of pages overlooking this square. Fun fact about the town hall is it's completely asymmetrical. The windows, the doors, everything is slightly different. Not even the tower is in the centre. Then it was time to admire the official mascot of Brussels, something as magnificent and genteel as the architecture. This is Mannequin Piss, the little pissing man. There's a story behind it, I'll link below. As for this, I'm not sure what the story is, but I'm fairly sure you can suck one and eat the other. Ah, Europe. So civilized, so refined. But in all honesty, the window displays are often works of art. I love these bone carvings. it was time for a well-earned beer in one of the many cafe bars on the sidewalk. We found this display of hairstyles through the ages. I love that there's art everywhere you look, even down the back streets. Art and old buildings. This disused church has been turned into a homeless shelter. At an eatery called Wolf. This was a new concept for me. Every type of food you can imagine, and you order at the table using your phone. I got a seasonal poke bowl, another new concept, and it was absolutely delicious. I ended the day very happy and very full.